still looking for that perfect gift for the hard-to-shop-for person on your list? Or maybe, for that matter, everyone on your list if you're like me and you haven't started shopping yet? Well, look no further, because now for a limited time only, you can have your very own Scrooge McDuck-style money swimming pool.
Oh.
Included with your money swimming pool are 8 million Swiss coins and apparently 4 attractive Swiss citizens to shovel it for you all day. The really tantalizing prospect of these gold coins, though, is that they just might change the world. Turns out they haven't just been sitting idly by basking in their golden beauty. On October 4th, all 8 million coins, one for each Swiss citizen, were dumped outside the Parliament building in Bern, Switzerland, to make a point about income inequality and to catalyze support for what sounds like a radical idea, guaranteeing every citizen a monthly minimum income, or what some supporters call a mincome. The coins were delivered along with the signatures necessary to guarantee a vote on this novel proposal. It's an idea that has quietly migrated from Switzerland to our own shores, where the gulf between rich and poor has sparked a debate on how to ensure that everyone has a chance to benefit from the fruits of our capitalist society. The basic idea is simple. Every non-incarcerated adult citizen gets a monthly check from the government. Other safety net programs are jettisoned to help pay for the mincome, and poverty is eliminated. A cheaper but slightly more complicated version of the mincome would phase out the payments as working income increases. Now, I know what you're thinking. This is some crazy left-wing utopian idea that only Marxists like Crystal Ball and Pope Francis could possibly support.
Yep.
But actually, while the idea is popular on the left for its potential to guarantee every American a human standard of living, the mincome has also found support on the right. Libertarian writer Matthew Feeney writes, instead of treating those who often through no fault of their own have fallen on hard times like children who are incapable of making the right choices about the food they eat or the drugs they may or may not choose to take, why not just give them cash? By just giving out cash rather than administering a patchwork of safety net programs, government bureaucracy would go down and the ability of people to make their own life choices would be respected. Now, I know what you're going to say next. Sounds great, Crystal, but next thing you know, we're going to have a nation full of lazy takers living off the government dole. Wait, I thought you already saw us as a nation full of lazy takers, 47%ers and such. Anyway, I digress. There's evidence that the disincentives to work are much smaller than you might think. In the 70s, residents in a small Canadian town were given a mincome, and economists studied the impact. Not only was poverty eliminated, but economists found that people made better choices and a whole range of outcomes improved. High school completion rates went up, hospitalization rates went down. According to one of the researchers, if you have a social program like this, community values themselves start to change. We tend to think of poverty, homelessness, despair as inevitable, but the mincome makes you realize, in a country as rich as ours, we allow those outcomes as a choice. We could decide to eliminate poverty, and it wouldn't even take a Christmas miracle to do it. All right, that does it for the cycle. Up next, the loser of Up Against the Clock. It's the Ari Melber Experience.